Hi. All right. I'm going to put Mr. Schiff on the phone, and then I guess are you going to transfer him to Mr. Parubi?
Yes, of course.
Great. Thank you.
Hi, how are you?
Hello, Mr. Schiff. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Chairman. I appreciate the opportunity to speak with you.
I know that you work for investigation regarding Trump and Russian government.
Yes.
We know some important information about it.
And that is documented as well in materials you want to provide to us?
Yes. Could I explain you where we are?
Yes, of course. But, you know, again, I would just caution that our Russian friends may be listening to the conversation, so I wouldn't share anything over the phone that you don't want them to hear.
No, I don't think that it will impact on our investigation.
Yes. Well, please, go ahead then.
In November 2013, Mr. Trump visited Moscow. He visited a competition Miss Universe, and there he met with Russian journalist and celebrity Ksenia Sobchak.
I'm sorry, can you explain that again? While he was in Moscow in November 2013, he met with a journalist and
Well, she's poor journalist, but anyway, she became famous because of Putin is her godfather.
Okay, Putin is a godfather, okay.
She's also known as a person who provides girls for escort for oligarchs, and she met with Trump and she brought him one our Russian girl, celebrity Olga Buzova, who also known as a person with a strange reputation.
Olga, and how do you spell her name?
Olga Buzova.
Buzova. So
yes.
Olga Buzova is a friend of the reporter Sovchek?
Yes, she's a friend of a reporter and I think the special agent of Russian Secret Service, Ksenia Sobchak.
That Sobchak is or Olga is?
No, Sobchak is Ksenia.
Okay, and so Buzova met with Trump in New York at some point after the 2013 Miss Universe
yes.
pageant.
Absolutely, and she got compromising materials on Trump after their short relations.
Okay, and what's the nature of the compromise?
Well, there were pictures of naked Trump.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And so Putin was made aware of the availability of the compromising material?
Yes, of course. Buzova shared those materials with Sobchak, and Sobchak shares those materials with Putin because she's a goddaughter of Putin, and Putin decided to press on Trump.
And the materials that you can provide to the committee or to the FBI, would they corroborate this allegation?
Sure, of course. When they were in Ukraine, we got their conversation by the phone where they discussed those compromising materials. We are ready to provide it to FBI.
So you have recordings of both Sovchek and Buzova where they're discussing the compromising material on Mr. Trump?
Absolutely. And we also know who was a mediator between Trump and Russian government, who met with ex-advisor of Trump, Mr. Flynn. It was a Russian singer, very famous singer, Arkady Ukupnik, who met with Mr. Flynn on Brighton Beach in Brooklyn in a special Russian cafe, Langeron.
What's the name of the cafe?
Langeron.
Langeron?
Yes, it's on the Brighton Beach.
Okay. And
it's a special, it's a Russian district in Brooklyn.
And do you know what was discussed?
They discussed many things, but the most interesting thing is they used a special password before their meetings. When they met each other, they said, weather is good on Deribasovskaya.
Weather
it rains.
Is good?
Yeah.
In where?
Weather is good on Deribasovskaya. There is a name of a street in Odessa.
Did you hear?
Yes, I did. So it's a street in Odessa.
Yes.
And the code word is weather is good on Deribasta?
Deribasovskaya. Deribasovskaya.
Deribasovskaya. Okay. Right. And I'll have my staff follow up to get spellings and more details on
yes.
that.
Yes.
And the second part of their password was it rains again on Brighton Beach.
It rains again on Brighton Beach.
Yes.
On that meeting, Ukupnik told Flynn that all those compromising materials will never be released if Trump will cancel all Russian sanctions.
Okay. Well, obviously, we would welcome a chance to get copies of those recordings. So we will try to work with the FBI to figure out, along with your staff, how we can obtain copies of those.
Of course, we will provide you all our copies of all our materials, but I also would like to let you know that Sobchak and Buzova will pretty soon visit our country, and we could arrest them and deliver them to your embassy, and we also could extradite them to your country, and you can put them to your special jail, Guantanamo.
Well, I'll be in touch with the FBI about this, and we'll make arrangements with your staff. I think it probably would be best to provide these materials to both our committee and to the FBI. And so we'll make arrangements between my staff and yours on how to facilitate that. And we'll also obviously let the FBI know about Buseva and Sovchak's planned travel to Ukraine.
I also advise you to check all Sobchak's visits in the U.S. because she was in the U.S. very often, and just to check what she did there actually. And I also would like to look at Russian cafe on Brighton Beach, Langeron, and especially on their head of Russian mafia, Uncle Misha.
Uncle Misha? And
yes.
He's in Brighton Beach.
Yes, he's head of Russian mafia, and he's located on that restaurant on Brighton Beach.
Okay.
I just want to advise you just to look at them, please.
Alrighty. Good. This is very helpful. I appreciate it. Anything else you wanted to add today?
Well, I hope that my information will be useful for you and your committee, and I also would like to advise you when you or your colleagues will meet Mr. Trump. I advise you to tell him first part of the password on the weather is good on Deribasovskaya, and look how his face will change the color.
And so those passwords were used with Mr. Trump?
Yes, correct.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. We will be back in touch with you through our staff to make arrangements to obtain these materials for our committee and for the FBI, and I appreciate you reaching out to us.
Well, let's be in touch, and I will wait for your response from FBI.
Excellent. I'll have them follow up as soon as possible, and I thank you again.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.